How about this one? Lenny, Harold's assistant. Is this the guy from the first game? Who was his assistant? He was human. Yeah, he was human. It was just insane. Hello there, my name's Lenny. How can I help you? Huh? What do you do here? Well, I help Harold, mostly. Well, when people get hurt, I help them out. You can heal people? Well, but before the war, I was a doctor. Before the war? But that must have been almost 160 years ago. That's true, but the radiation seems to have given us ghouls a longer lifespan. Of course, it took almost everything else away. Took things away. Well, yes. We look like freaks. We don't have any skin, for Christ's sake. Well, I guess you have seen better days. You could say that. I'd trade in all these years to be a normal person again. Well, not much hope of that, I suppose. If those fools in Vault City would share their medical technology, I'm sure we could cleanse the excess of radiation and heal ourselves. They won't help you? You've been to Vault City? Then you tell me what you think the chances of getting help from those bigots is. Well, might as well watch a paper dog chase an asbestos cat through hell. What? Watch a paper dog chase an asbestos cat through hell. That's some good dialogue here, I gotta tell you that. I'm sorry to hear that, but I think you're right. Let me ask you about something else. Hello again. How can I help you? I haven't left. Help Harold do what? Help Harold administer the town. There's always more paperwork to do. What else did you say you did here? So you can heal people. Can you provide healing? Yes, what do you need? I guess I don't need anything right now. Okay. Lenny, have you ever heard of something called a Garden of Eden creation kit? A Garden of Eden creation kit? I heard that the Vault City had one of those. That's the only one I've ever heard of, though. Well, my ancestor, the Vault Dweller, said that Vault 13 owes us one. I need to find it. Well, I didn't actually meet the Vault Dweller, but I saw him once. You saw the Vault Dweller? Where? Harold met the Vault Dweller. It was a long time ago, in a place called the Necropolis. A lot of us ghouls lived there. One day I saw someone running through the city. Yeah, it was quite a time. With Set and all that. Running? Yes, running. You see, we ghouls can't run much anymore, so I knew it was an outsider when I saw him. They ran by so close I could have touched him. I wish that I had joined the Vault Dweller. What? You pretty much stopped stuttering, didn't you? How mean? You wanted to join my grandsire? Grandmother. Yes, I had the chance of a lifetime and I blew it. What do you mean? Later I heard that the Vault Dweller had fixed our water system. The Vault Dweller saved us. All of us. Do you understand? It didn't matter that we were ghouls. For once it didn't matter. We were people again. We were worth saving. My ancestor is the founder of our tribe. That memory is revered amongst my people. Later I heard that the Vault Dweller destroyed the source of the mutant army. The Vault Dweller saved all of us, human and ghoul alike. I could have been a part of that, but I lacked the courage. I've never forgiven myself. Oh God. I'm not going to pick this, I'm just going to read it. Well, a lot of people are cowards deep down inside. It's not something to be overly ashamed of. You're just weak. Goodbye. That's so mean. I'm sure that the work you do here amongst the ghouls is value and meaning. It's good to hear my ancestor. Let me ask you something. I am following in my ancestor's footsteps. Would you like another chance? Will you join me? Can I have a fourth party member? I'm happier than a bull Brahmin in a pasture full of cows. I'd be honored to join you. I'm maybe old, and I can't move too darn fast. At least was a not for long, but I can sure patch you up when you need it. I'm glad that you can join me. I'm sure that your healing skills will come in handy. Okay. Well, okay, but I sure don't want to be left all alone here. I'll stick close to you. Need to talk to you about your gear. Alright, if you think it's really a good idea. I need to know what kind of weapons you can use. Well, I don't like to use weapons unless I really have to, but I suppose I could use a knife, I think. I can use a spear, at least I used to be able to. If I really had to, I think I could handle a rifle. If only they weren't so loud. I'm a healer, not a fighter. Your stutter went away again. Alright, let's go combat control and trade. You got a pipe rifle. With one shot of something. Okay, let's give you this spear then. For when you fire once. I don't have any knives currently. Weapon used 10mm jacketed hollow point. I don't know how, I don't even have it. Armor used none. Don't have anything. Defensive coward custom. Wait. Oh. You know, I'm not completely sure I ever saw this screen. Stimpaks would hurt a bit. He has a healing thing, so I'm not sure if I need to give him stimpaks. Stay close. Attack the weakest. Yeah, attack whoever's attacking me. Okay, so he's got doctor skill. Let me take a look at Sulik. His AI's been messed up for a while.
What you be needing?
That was a weird sound that happened when he talked. I can't choose that with him. Melee than ranged. Stay close to me. Attack was for talking. Okay. Still don't know why he doesn't attack sometimes. Where's Myron? Did Myron leave? Because I got this new guy? Oh, there he is.
So, you finally wise up, beautiful?
Oh,
finally realize that I'm the only one for you?
Please shut up. Run away. Your finger hurts. Yeah, you can't select these. So, range then melee. Have him stay close to me too. No, you know what? Yeah, slap the enemy. I like the way it's I'll just cancel. Attack who? Whoever's attacking me, I like. The Sulix AI is messed up. I just really can't. Thought I could fix that. Thought there was something I could do to fix that, but nope. Alright. So, welcome, Lenny. That sound is quite alarming. I thought there was another ghoul back here. There is. Our atomic reactor makes me glow with pride. Huh? Literally. Cool, we got a book of science. Don't attack me. Alright, I'm done here. I'm not gonna steal something from someone in the room, so we're done in here. Every time I hear that sound, I think it's the, you know, basically this. But it's not that. Alright, so I haven't looked in here. Some more ghouls in here. Greetings! If Vault City people were like you, we wouldn't have a problem with them. Oh, that's very nice of you. Hello there, my smooth-skinned friend. I never did ask Harold about smooth-skinned. I mean, I know why, but why he called us that. Hello there, friend. Oh, they're so friendly. I had a feeling it might be like that. Let's not do anything to piss them off, though, okay? Y'all coming in? Come on in. I want to close the door. Don't think I can. Nice! Right away. They don't need it. Nothing in there. Another pot. Nothing there. Okay, so I got a flare and $8. Still weird looking at coins and thinking of them as dollars. A wooden table in fair to middling condition. I'm running outside. What is this? What is this? A bowl? Oh, to crush and separate grains. I got mortar and pestle, basically. Alright. You're not like other smooth skins. Another compliment? You're gonna make my smooth skin blush. A crude but effective toilet. There are some leaves dropped into the hole to manage the odor. Would that even work? Leaves? Oh, reactor 5. Okay, by the way. Okay, still zero. Good. Hello there, friend. Hello there, my smooth skin friend. Give me a giant cola. Oh, have I been in there? The harp? No, I haven't been in there. Let's go in here first. Hi. You're not like other smooth skins. A curtain. Very nice looking bed. I can't get there. Because I got too many people. Should have known this would be a problem. Who else do I have to move? Lenny. I don't mean to be an obstacle. Well, apparently you are. Rush, rush, rush. Okay, take it easy. I'm moving. Sorry, I didn't mean to get in your way. He's so nice, though. I'm gonna risk it. Bookcase. Okay. Box of noodles and meat jerky. Check out the harp in a little bit, actually. I've been here, manager's office. Okay, there's Brahmin over here. Yeah, not much to see. Junk. A ghoul farmer. Oh, I didn't even see that guy. Sure has been dry lately. Sure could use some more rain. Now I heard a funny sound. Nope. So I wanted to make sure my skin wasn't getting burned off or something. Okay, so what do you got left? The harp? And that's it? I believe so. Where am I even coming from? Okay. Oh, I'm there. This is the ghoul bar. I am the dumbest person I've ever met. Let's sing a song. Hey there, smooth skin. Ask Woo... Who? Ask Wooz to tell you a story. And then the heads do what? I just don't understand, Wooz. Buy us a drink, smooth skin. Too good to drink with us? Boy, am I thirsty. Anybody else hiding? If someone paid you a lot of money and you could use steel britches, you might consider sitting in this chair. Okay. He seems pissed. Girly poster. A tall ghoul with long hair. I am Wooz. What do you want? Wooz. What do you do here? I run this place. Are you dumb? I sell drinks, trade for things, tell stories, and play tragic. Tell stories? I've got this great story. It's really funny. You see, there's this head, right? Mort? A head? Yeah, it's a head, but it's not attached to a body. You see, it's been severed. A severed head, I see. And this becomes entertaining when... Just hold on a minute. The severed head, you see, it's in hell. And it flies around there, you know, in hell. And it runs into all kinds of famous people there. Ho ho. Wait. A severed head is in hell and it flies around doing what? Well, it's doing stuff. Hehe. You know, it's got things that it wants to do, or maybe things it's forced to do. The point is, it's doing stuff, you know, there in hell. Oh, God. I just can't stand it. You kind of obsess about this, don't you? Were you and your mother close? Did you ever have problems with bedwetting? Oh, any choice but to ask this. No, you just don't understand. It's all about a severed head. Get it? It's funny. How could you not think about a severed head in hell of all places and not laugh? Wooz, I don't know you very well. I'm pretty sure I don't want to. However, I can say without fear of exaggeration that you need help. Immediate, competent help. I'll try to win him over. Oh, I see. Why, yes, of course. That's very funny. Heh heh. I just can't contain my amusement. But enough enjoyment. Oh, my splitting sides. I need to ask you something. See? I told you it was funny. Is there anything else you need? Play Tragic? Are you dumb? Tragic the Garnering, oh god, is the most addictive thing since Jet. Play dumb. What's Jet? It's a drug that comes from New Reno. Were you born yesterday or just dumb? Oh, that Jet. Well, sure, I knew about that. Tell me more about this Tragic the Garnering. Just like I was saying, Tragic the Garnering is the game to play. Tell me more. Well, Tragic the Garnering isn't just a game, it's an obsession. Not a cologne, either. Some think that the way it changes a person's life is tragic, but they just don't understand. No, really, it's wonderful. You should play. Just once. The first box of cards is free. A little something from me to you. Thanks. Hey, these look great. You tear the wrapping off. I just love that smell. That's just the first part. Now that you're one of us, want to play a game? These you won't like very much. Sure, but you're going to have to show me how. Well, it's simple, really. Even someone dumb can understand it. First, you build a play deck out of the cards that you have, and then you... You say you deal to the third player unless it's Thursday? Okay, I think I've got it now. Let's play. I won! Bleep! You! You are dumb. I have crushed you. Now I can build an even better deck with your cards. Yeah, you won. Goodbye. Wait. So I got these cards and then lost them just like that? That's probably due to my luck stat. We got free cards and lost them. Tell me about this place. Not much to tell, really. Just a bunch of ghouls clinging tenaciously to the ass end of life. No, I mean, tell me about this bar. Well, the harp's named after a favorite hangout that I used to have before the war. I guess it's just a reminder of times past. Sort of a joke on the only way we're going to get a better deal, too. Before the war? But that was a long time ago. It sure was a long time ago. How do you think ghouls are made? You think some of us just got up one fine day and said to ourselves, "Gee, I wonder where we'd like to have my flesh rotting off my body." Well, no, I didn't. Say, how do you make a ghoul? With silver bells and cockle shells and... Boy, you are dumb, aren't you? Severe radiation, that's how. How do you think? You know, many bombs go boom, flash of light and heat. Flesh burns off, but you don't quite die. You don't quite die type severe radiation? I didn't think so. Bleep you very much for bringing back all these intensely painful memories. Asshole. We're a town of leftovers. Slightly overcooked leftovers. I prefer medium rare myself. Hey, let me ask you something else. Tell stories. Okay, I thought there might be a few different stories. No. Apparently can't play again. Have you heard of something called a Garden of Eden creation kit? You mean the device included with every vault that's supposed to be used when the people leave the vault in order to reestablish civilization? Yes, that's it. Where can I find one? I just told you that every vault has one. Does this look like a vault to you? Are you dumb? Why are you looking for a geck here? Try a vault. Where is the nearest vault? Let me guess, in Vault City. Nearest vault? Gee, I don't know. Maybe you could ask the people in Vault City where a vault might be. Vault City's just south of here. You are dumb, aren't you? I feel like I'm talking to Antoine Dodson. You are dumb. You are so dumb. I knew that. I was just testing you. Jeez, Wooz, you're so smart. Tell me something else. I'm gonna trade with him. Let's see what kind of drinks he has. I want a drink. You want a drink, huh? Well, we've got our very own Gamma Gulp beer at $5 a bottle, and for special occasions, our Rotten Gum rum at $12 a bottle. Gulp? Yeah, Gamma Gulp beer. You deaf or something? Alright, let's trade. Trade? I'm always ready to trade tragic cards. I've got a couple of old Vox movies. Movies? A Black Dahlia and some rare earths. What the hell are you talking about? Oh. I don't know what you're on, but I hope you have some in inventory to trade. Okay, there's a deck of tragic cards. Just wondering how much those might be. Yeah, I'm not... Eventually I might buy those. This is a deck of cards for a collectible card game. Looks like it could be an expensive hobby if you got hooked. Yeah, really. Rotgut. Gamma Gulp Beer. Very strong liquor or cleaning fluid, you decide. Gamma Gulp Beer. A bottle of Gamma Gulp Beer. It glows in the dark. That's all he's got. You buy my Boxo noodles? Jeez, you don't even have enough for that. These smoked and dried chunks of beast flesh remain chewy, delicious, and even somewhat nutritious for years and years and years. Alright. How much is this? Just $10. Just got rid of those. Oh. Alright, done in here. Oh, I'm stuck in here now. I'm not gonna read the science book right now. Meaning what? It's... Time will pass when I do that. And I'll lose some of this rad resistance. I might even be irradiated when I'm done. Poseidon oil. Alright, so I'm gonna read that when we get out of here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time when we go into Reactor 5, aka Poseidon Oil. Tune in then, and thanks for watching, and always seek adventure.